Okay, siguro simple nga natin ang mga issue dito, no? Alam natin na ang lupaing ito, sinabi ni ano ni Miss Sablas ay binili ng kanyang kapatid, no? At one point in time. Pero ang tanong, pwede po bang magtayo ng resort o kahit anumang building, bahay, anumang istruktura sa protected area na yon? Pwede ba yon?
Ang guidelines po ng DENR, kahit na ito'y isang land title ng isang pribadong individual, meron pa rin restrictions at saka regulations, no? Pinahintulutan iyon, pero it has to follow the guidelines set forth by the DENR.
Okay, so isang paglilinaw, pinapayagan natin sa Pilipinas ang pagtatayo ng mga istruktura sa isang declared protected area. Are you sure about that? Is that clear under the law?
Yun na nga, ang merong sabi nga ng isang board member natin dito sa province ng Bon, merong ambiguity doon sa guidelines na yon, no? As to its restrictions and regulation, it has to be well-defined and specific, no? At
No, because
kaya nga,
when we say there are restrictions, it means we're allowing to build. So that's why my first question is, under the law, are we allowed to build in a protected area? Yun muna.
yung protect ang Captain Speak Jen, ma'am, title po 'yun, no? Yung sa portion ng claim, yung ika nga yung sa ibaba, dinideclare 'yun ng as multiple use zone ata ng Protected Area Management Board, yung PAMB. Kasi may PAMB resolution naman po yung establishment, yung Captain Speak. No?
Okay,
At
so what you are
in-state po
saying,
doon,
kung
it is stated in that resolution yung mga structure, proposed structures na like swimming pool, cottages among others, pati yung function hall, in-state po doon sa isang PAMB resolution.
anong sinabi? Pwede yon o bawal yon?
Pwede po, sabi dito, yung sa Resolution Number 21, Series of 2022, itong the final development will include the following: swimming pool, slides, show area and dressing room, proposed wave pool, 10 cottages, function hall, and 10 rentable rooms, no? Ito po ay nasa isang prefiguratory statement ng resolution. And then the project area is located at the flat portion and it is within the multiple use zone of Chocolate Hills, no? Protected area per proposed zoning. The area is a titled property owned by Edgar Buton, the owner or applicant of the resort, with TC number 37138. So napapaloob po rito at ina-identify naman. At kaya nga na-issuehan natin yon, no? Dahil doon.
Natin, sino ang mayor na nakaupo noon nung inisyuhan po ito ng permit para lang malinaw, kasi binili daw niya ang lupain ng 2005, nagsimula ang development ng 2018. 5 ektarya ang pag-aari ni Mr. Button, pero 2 ektarya ng lote ang tinayuan po niya. So sino ang mayor noon?
Actually, nag-umpisa yung application sa year 2018.
Okay.
2018 po, ma'am, no? Sa February, lumabas yung resolution number 1 ng PAMB doon sa application nila. 2018, ang mayor pa noon ay yung former mayor, no?
At anong pangalan niya? Anong pangalan ng former mayor?
Former Mayor Ricardo Suarez.
Okay. Pero, so si Mayor Suarez ang nag-approve ng permits. Just for the record, siya nag-approve.
Hindi ko matandaan, ma'am, kasi we are talking about the application of the establishment doon sa PAMBI resolution.
Okay. Pero sa pagtatayo, kasi alam naman natin, hindi ka pwedeng magtayo ng kung ano-ano sa Pilipinas na walang approval nung City Hall o provincial government. So, para po magdala ng materyales, lahat yun kailangan may permit.
Opo. Nang pumutok yung COVID-19, nag-stop po sila. No, yung establishment ayon for more than 2 years ata, nag-stop. Mm-hmm. At bago lang sila nag-apply for renewal.
Okay, I think you've said certain points here. Pinayagan po ito ng konseho rin, itong pagtayo, tama ba? Or mayor lang po?
Mayor's permit. Yeah, business permit. At okay. Nakapasi din ito sa mga pertinent papers na sinasubmit nila sa atin.
Okay. All right. So unang-una ang sinasabi niyo ang declaration ng area na ito, the Chocolate Hills is a protected area, but then dinefine. Tama ba 'to? Dineclare o dinefine ng LGU. You can correct me, sir, baka mali po ako. Ng LGU ang flat area sa may Chocolate Hills, hindi po yung tuktok. May flat area doon na dinefine ng LGU as a multi-use zone. Tama?
Hindi po yung LGU ang nagde-define, ma'am.
Sino po nagde-define nun? Sino po?
Ang Protected Area Management Board ay isa pong worldwide organization po iyan. Uh-oh. From different municipalities na merong protected area.
Okay. Alright. So, ang PAMBI, ang Protected Area Management Board, ang nagdeklara nun na multi-use zone. Tama?
Yun ang proposed. Bali, pinopropose nila
pa lang ba to? Or approved? Kasi kung proposed, bakit nakapagpatayo ng resort doon? So ano? Ganito, sir, let's stick to the facts. Let's stick to the facts. Don't worry. Let's stick to the facts. What is the definition of that zone today? Hindi po ito proposed, pwedeng ganito, hindi. Ano ang definition?
Ito po ang nakasulat sa... Yes, ma'am, I will just basing my statement from the resolution number 21, whereas the project area is located at the flat portion and it is within the multiple use zone of CNHMPA or protected area per proposed zoning. The area is a titled property owned by Edgar Buton, now the owner of the resort.
Sir, okay, so there are two words
Is another area here, ma'am. Whereas the area is designated as lot 3561 with cadastral survey 050-D, containing an area of 10,068 square meters, situated at Canmano, Sagbayan, of Block 1, map number 696, project number 2, dated November, and found to be within alienable and disposable as per certification issued by DENR Sendro Tagbilaran. So the area, not only within the multiple use zone, but also within alienable and disposable as per certification issued by DENR Sendro Tagbilaran.
Okay, all right. So you're reading, what you're reading from me is from the mayor's office? That resolution.
No. I'm reading the resolution of the Protected Area and Management Board, PAMBI.
Okay, PAMBI to. Okay, so...
This is not LGU Sagbayan.
Okay, sir. So, is it correct? PAMBI has declared this area kung saan nakatayo ang resort as a multi-use zone.
I cannot speak for the PAMBI, ma'am. I'm just reading their resolution.
Oh, but what are you understanding? But you're the municipal information officer. I mean, what do you understand from that resolution? Is it or no?
It is within the multiple use zone of
Chocolate Hills area.
That's in the statement of the resolution. I cannot go beyond that statement.
Okay, so based on that statement, it's within the multiple use zone. So my next question is, may nilabag ba para sa inyo? You are the municipal information officer. Etong Captain's Peak Resort.
As a matter of fact, ma'am, we have...
sila or wala?
As to my own knowledge, we received the notice of the request from the DNR about their supposed violations. Now I have the here in my hand, and I just received it yesterday. Yesterday, March 13, 2024.
Can you read the supposed violation, sir? So while you're looking for it,
It's now in my hand, ma'am.
Okay,
this is addressed to Mayor. The subject is request for assistance for the implementation of notice of violations issued to Captain's Peak Resort at Canmano, Sagbayan, Bohol. Dear Honorable Suarez, good day. This is reference to the issued notices of violations dated September 6, 2023 from the Office of the Paso Pedro and Environmental Management Bureau, EMB, dated January 2, 2024 for the developments of Captain's Peak Resort at Canmano, Sagbayan within the Chocolate Hills Natural Monument for not securing an Environmental Compliance Certificate or ECC.
So that's one.
As required by the CHNM PAMBI Resolution Number 21, Series of 2022. Please be informed that due to their failure to comply to these sets of requirements or conditions, the said resort was advised to voluntarily undergo a temporary closure. However, it was recently reported that the above stated resort still operates even without full compliance to the issued notice of violations. In this regard, we hereby request the assistance from your good office in implementing the conditions stated issued notice of violations of the Captain's Peak Resort at Canmano, Sagbayan, Bohol.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, that's it.
Yeah. All right, sir. We don't have enough time, so just a few questions. Okay, number one, after that letter from the DENR, what will the mayor's office do? Will you implement the closure?
As a matter of fact, ma'am, yesterday we have issued a revocation and cancellation of the business permit to operate. So we now have the order, and we will serve it today to cease and desist all its operations and ongoing constructions.
Okay, next question. Sir, taga-Bohol po kayo. Sa totoo lang, gaano karami po ba ang resort na nakatayo doon sa flat area ng Chocolate Hills? Yung labeled as multi-level purpose zone.
Pag sinasabi nating Chocolate Hills, ma'am, actually it's scattered all throughout 4 to 5 municipalities in the province of Bohol. It's not just within Sagbayan. And in fact, most of the Chocolate Hills are found in Carmen, in the municipality of Carmen. And I really do not know as to how many infrastructures constructed sa mga flat portion ng mga Chocolate Hills sa buong apat o limang municipalidad or 6 municipalities rather. But here in Sagbayan, we only have Captain's Peak and Sagbayan Peak.
So yung Sagbayan Peak, isang resort din yun.
Mas mauna yun kaysa Captain's Peak.
Okay, katabi ba yun ng Captain's Peak?
No, hindi katabi.
Malayo.
Malayo. From end to end yun.
Oo. So parang lumalabas dito sa ating pag-uusap ang pagkakamali ng Captain's Peak, hindi kumuha ng ECC. Pero ang malinaw, pinayagan sila ng PAMBI yung area na yon at nung LGU na magtayo kasi nga it's defined as a multi-purpose zone. Tama?
Yeah, kaya nga sa amin, ma'am, when we learned yesterday, kasi ang sa amin, hindi kami nakatanggap ng official communication, kopya ng temporary closure order ng DENR. Even up to now, we have not received. We just learned it yesterday from social media. But right there and then, upon receipt of this non-compliance, the mayor has issued an order for the cancellation and revocation of its business operation.
Okay, all right. So I think at this point is what's sad, what's good and both bad is this only came to light when a netizen posted it, right? Kumbaga nung pinost ito, nagkaroon ng mga reaksyon, pero hindi malalaman na yung resort na ito nag-ooperate ng walang ECC. So ang tanong ko nga, dapat
Actually,
kahit
it is an old issue, Ma'am Karen, no? Ito po yung issue na yan, last year of August 2023. Kaya nga nagkaroon ng series of hearings and investigation yung Sangguniang Panlalawigan together with DENR of Bohol, no? At umaatin tayo doon sa mga hearings na yon. So it was an old issue actually. It was only revived just because of that by the vlogger, no?
Well, on that note, unfortunately, we don't have enough time. So I want to thank you so much, Tagbayan Municipal Information Officer Felito Pon, for joining me today. Thank you, sir.
Thank you so much, Ma'am Karen, for having with you in this your program.
All
Thank you
right,
so much.
maingat po kayo, sir, and please keep us updated.